morning, everyone. I don't like the feeling that I'm feeling, but nevertheless, I will try to get as much water inside to ensure that when the water come out, I won't get dehydrated. Ask the praise team, the musician, to do a selection for me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. You know that one? If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Take my hands, Lord. Speak to me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Take my hands, Lord, and my feet. Take my heart, Lord, speak to me. If you can use anything, can use me. That should be the cry of our hearts as we contemplate the passing of the old year and we enter into the new year. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Are you available for God to use you? Certainly. If he can use anything, there's no doubt that he can use you. Good morning again to you, in case I didn't tell you good morning. And Happy New Year's to those who I didn't get the chance to say Happy New Year's to you. You're in the right place. You're in the house of the Lord. And it's good to see the faces as I look down, and God is good. The portion for consideration is Exodus chapter 4. I will read a few verses from there. So while you find time and you turn to it, I didn't know why I carried 2 kerchiefs this morning. But after a while, I understand why. I saw 2 same type, but I choose to take up one and put it in each pocket. I remember the days when I used to use kerchief or rock to kind of put in the back pocket to build the bottom, because the bottom was flat, because maybe the pants that I wore at the time. These days, even though I'm getting older, there's no need for that. So that wasn't the reason why I brought the 2 thing. One, maybe Lord knows things best, and I was trying to avoid to see if the mood could change as I sat in my seat and reflected that when I come up here, you know, I will be in a different mood, and that I will not break them before you. But God will have his way. And if God can use anything, certainly he can use you. And the reading of scripture goes on like this. And Moses answered, said, But behold, they will not believe me, nor hearken unto my voice. For they will say, the Lord had not appeared unto thee. And the Lord said unto him, what is it? What is that in thine hand? And he said, a rod. And he said, cast it on the ground. And he cast it on the ground, and it became a serpent. And Moses fled from before it. And the Lord said unto Moses, put forth thine hand, and take it by the tail. And he put forth his hand, and caught it, and it became a rod in his hand. That they may believe that the Lord, God of their father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, appeared to thee. May God bless the reading of his word unto our hearts and glorify his name. And our brother, Uncle Ruan, would say, bless thy words unto our hearts and glorify thy name. As we enter into, we are now in 2024, we have passed through a difficult year, 2023, and God has seen fit to allow us to see 2024. And we said, we thank you, Lord, for your goodness and your mercy. I will say to you, for those who are worrying, that you don't have to worry, because I won't be long. And so therefore, you'll be out here in a very short time. But I want to share a few thoughts with you and say to you that throughout the years, God has been using people. And what is clear is that God uses anybody. Anybody. Anyone. He used people, he used things, circumstances. God decide who he wants to use. And for you who are part of the congregation, I say to you that God wants to use you. And you should say amen to that. Because as we enter into this new year, let us be clear in our minds that there's a lot of work that needs to be done. And God wants to use you to glorify himself and bring others to his kingdom. And you must prepare to work. You must prepare yourself for work, hard work. God wants to use you. And so, the cry should be, if you can use anything, Lord, certainly you can use me. As we look at Moses and in chapter 3, the different, as God met Moses in the burning bush and present himself to him, and then the dialogue pursue. And Moses began to make a lot of excuses to make the story very short. But in chapter 4, God have a next dialogue with Moses. And God was sending Moses on a mission to deliver his people. And God said to him, and the excuse that Moses was using, that they were really valid, you know. You can't send people to God, especially those people, and you can't prove who God is. People going to ask you, come tell me, man, who is this God you're talking about? And you're going to prove yourself to them, especially to Pharaoh. So Moses said, I'm not going to believe me, man. No way. And then God decided that he went to use a sign to show him, to say, take this to them and tell them, tell Pharaoh what happened. And so God said to him, what is it in your hand? And he said, a rod, simple rod. God said, throw it down. Moses did that. And the rod changed. And of course, just like anybody else, I become a little bit afraid. And to Moses, back off. And God said, take it up. But God was good. God said, hold it by the tail. Because there's no way you're going to touch that head. And Moses hold it by the tail. And it becomes a rod again. And as we meditate upon the whole idea that if you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. The question is, what do you have to offer to the Lord? What is in your hand? What is in your hand? Oftentimes, we made a mistake that we choose people based on our own ideas of what we expect from them. Sometimes, and rightly so, because of their educational background, the personal ability to speak well, the personal ability to sing, and all those things. But I say to you that despite your shortcomings, God can use you. You know, I've been to quite a few churches when I was much younger. And I go to church wearing that people are singing and they have their lead singer, just like your praise team. And believe me, as I stand here and tell you, them can't hold a good note. Them just can't sing well. I've seen some choirs, and believe me, when them go up there and they do their thing, because I'm exposed to good singing, I said to myself, wow. But I tell you this, and believe me when I tell you this, that church, those believers, those singers, is all they got, all they have. And believe me, they use them well. And they sung from their heart. And when they sung and they sing and praise God, things happen. People are blessed. And the church say it was good for them to be here because they sung from their heart. I've seen many great singers choose the wrong song and make a fool of themselves. I say to you, regardless what voice you have, there's a song for you. And I've seen people who can't sing well, pick the right song, put the right song together, and done well, makes million. Don't worry, be happy. And the person just keep on saying the words. And believe me, I'm saying to you, do not allow anyone to despise you. Use what God gives to you. Use it well. Sing from your heart. Sing with meaning. And exercise your faith and your trust in God. And God will do well for you. Too often, I've seen many of those churches. And they grow from strength to strength. And believe me, the believers in just that church, they accept what they have and they offer it to God with a sincere heart, a heart of thanksgiving. God is not going to ask you for what you don't have. God is not going to ask you for what he has not given to you. Use what you have for the Lord. God will bless it, turn it around, and bring glory to his name. And people will glorify God because of that. So I say to you, that God is saying to you, he wants to use you. And if he can use anything, believe me, he can use you. How about it in the family? And sometimes you want, you know, you keep on telling it, if it was like so and so. And so on and so forth. At the workplace, you are a leader, maybe a supervisor, you're the head of a department. And for some reason, you didn't get the opportunity to pick who you have. They must just trust upon you. The church, the leaders of the church, didn't get an opportunity to say, Lord, save that one, bring in that one, they become of talent. God just save people, add them to the church, and the leaders have to accept who they have and work with them. Work with them. Use them the best way you can because that is all you have. And they can bring glory to the Lord. I've seen too often people are looking outside and not willing to use what they have inside. And believe me, when you turn them loose, you say, what wait? Guess what? You never give the person a chance. Because when Christ is in the vessel, you not only can smile at the storm, Christ can turn anything into anything to glorify his name. I had an interaction with a young man, sent a message to me. Not a young man, he's older than I am. He's retired. Sent a message to me. And he said to me, Brother Leon, boy, I love the Lord. He said, Jesus sweet, him sweet bad. I may enjoy my Christian life. He said, Leon, and I look at your business now, a serious business that. He said, I remember when I come to your supervisor and say, I want to go home. I just plan a lie. And I come to you and I tell you, because I want to leave early. I know how to tell a lie. He said, I remember when I have my phone and I can't put on my phone if I can't in the bathroom with me. Because if the lady see the phone, I will be in trouble. Sometimes if I go to the bathroom, I answer the phone. But no, I can't put on my phone anywhere because I trust the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, Jesus, sweet bad. He said, Leon, you so terrible about God, you know. Not that you never believe, you know. But you used to encourage me. But I chase him for myself. And boy, I feel light, man. I feel light. Because all the burdens have been lifted. I don't have to lie no more. I don't have to plan no lie. And you see, when you never tell lie, you feel free. But among that, he said something to me. He said, I remember how you used to protect us. Now, let us say this to you. You see, when people come from the grassroots and many years ago, and they come into the industry, they work themselves from the bottom. And it, as a result of their ability to do the work, not their educational background, and them growing in the system, and they know the system well, very good mechanic, but they are not able to read, write, and comprehend properly. Some of them barely can sign their name. You can imagine a big man When him say training time come, him start get nervous. And start worry. Them go and give me a test. Do I have to write something? And over the years, I've protected those guys because what? They are my worker and they serve me well. And I saw good in them. Some of them are the best mechanic I've never known. But God has trusted me with them. And they are all that I have with all the shortcomings. I protect them with everything that I have. Who has God given to you? Do you protect them? Do you use them the best way you know, or because you don't have no other chance, no other opportunity, because they are the ones that God has given to you? And he said to me, listen, you protect me. Sometimes I talk to the person and say, don't give them the test. I inquire before, and I go to the person and say, no worry yourself, everything is okay. I could depend on those guys to use their memories when they can't do certain things, something else can work well. Those guys have a memory. They say a memory of an elephant. What the point I'm bringing to you? The point I'm bringing to you, whosoever God put before you, use them the best way you can. Protect them and use them to bring glory to God. Don't complain. If you're children, use them. At the workplace, use them. At the school, use them. What you have in your hand, a rod, God said, throw it down. And God changed that. For those of us, you have met the Lord Jesus Christ. And he revealed himself to you. Yes. And when he revealed himself to you, you have come to trust him as your personal Lord and Savior. And he has given you a testimony. He asks you what you have, and you throw it down before the Lord. And God do something, a miracle. And you are here today, a different person, doing great things because God turn around what you have and make it into a blessing. And you should say amen for that. Amen. What are you doing with your testimony? God is sending you out as he sent out Moses. And he wants you to use your testimony to bring glory to God. He wants you to go out there and tell others about God's goodness and God's mercy. And to share with them, oh God has not only transformed your life as a person, but oh God has provided for you. Sometimes the people who God can send it to you, you don't have no control over it, you know. It's not who you want help from, you know. It's who want to help you. It's who God wants to help you. And some of the things what you're looking for and things that can make a big difference, believe me, as I stand here, they are just what people call aesthetics. The musician, I thank God for them, because I remember we used to sing without music. And you couldn't clap piano. You didn't know that at Galilee? Yes. And I know when we start Capricorn. And we thank God for the leadership. They start bringing musicians. And how much they have blessed our hearts and blessed our soul. And you should say amen for that. But guess what? As time progresses, you will understand clearly that people going to get used to the music, used to the musician, and what going to stand out, and what going to stand the test of time is believers who are committed to the Lord and trust him and willing to serve him. Commitment is the key. Are you committed to God? I've seen many churches with better musicians like this. And I've seen over the years, as time goes on, the benches become to get empty, and empty, they get used to the music. Our brother Kolash last week spoke on faith. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. And they that come to him must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently what? Seek him. And read in Hebrews 11 verse 1, that faith is the substance of things what? Hope for, the evidence of things what? Not seen. And we were encouraged to have faith and trust in God. Believe me as I stand here before you. All these good things that we have put in the church to make things better, it's not bad, but without faith, trust, and commitment, believe me, it won't stand for long. You must have a church full of people coming to the service, singing nice songs, going out there and doing nothing because they are not committed. And I tell you something else. Other religion, they don't have the fancy things. The Muslim and thing, a lot of rituals. But because they are committed, they are growing what? Numbers. And they will do anything to represent, to spread what they believe in, or about you, or about I. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. I remember a story about 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 11. About 16, there was a famine, and Elijah was told by God to go by the brook, drink water, and that the bird or raven should feed him with bread. I wonder how that would work in today's day if God had tell you. Remember, God, you know, the God who will have what? All things. Sometimes the things we think we desire, we don't really need it, you know. And if we really allow God for feed, we're going to trouble, you know. We're going to run, you know. Just like children in the wilderness, you know. So God gives his servant bread and water. But the brook dry up. Yes, the brook dry up. Because there was a famine. And so God instructed him to go to a widow. You know, some of us, when God instructs us to go somewhere, expect God to go and send us to a mansion, you know. Yeah? Yeah? To one of the big leaders, them house, you know, where them can give things in a buffet style and things like that. You know? And you can get as much as you want. But I don't understand God sometimes. But he's past finding out. So God sent him to a local widow. Yeah? And guess what happened? What makes things look even worse is that she only have what? A little oil, a little flour. You can imagine that. And she was catching some water and gathering some stick to cook the little one meal for herself and her son. The man said, beg him some water. And she gave him some water. I said, wait a little, drink the water. I said, look, I want more than that. I want something we are cooking. I want you. They give me what? First. Cook and give me first. The lady said, look here, this thing I'm going to have is, when I cook this one meal, I just went and lay down and wait for Mr. Death to come. Because there's no more left. The servant of God said, serve me first. And promised to her that water. Her oil never run out. She did that, and glory be to God. She didn't get a new buckler oil. The jar didn't fill up. The same amount in there, each time she threw it out. the same amount come back, eh? Someone wants to look what that somebody from supermarket could have carry and say, see, a big jug of oil here. Didn't work that way. Sometimes the people who you are looking for to help you, they are not outside here, they are right in here. Sometimes the person who you are seeking counsel from is not that family life, they are right in here. Use what you have first. And when you use it, and it can't work, go outside, go look for more. But don't try, don't forsake trying what you have. The way we think and we perceive things, it's difficult for God to use us, because if God sends us, I say, Lord, no, you send me this, so, and the devil. Because when you match it out and look upon the person who God sent you to, I say, no, sir, but they must suffer like me too. How can you send them to me? And when you go to the person who says, see with them have, you say, but Lord, let me come at the wrong place. You say, sorry, here. Yeah? Or you say, oh, the condition. You say, Lord. But the servant of God was willing to listen to what? God. And if you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Don't watch the voice. Don't, for those who just got baptized. Yes. Don't let anyone despise your youth. You can do great things for God. Amen? Amen. We need people to work. But we need people who love people. If you don't love people, it can't work. You must love people. Moses loved people. You must have an heart of compassion where you care for people just like what? Or you care for yourself. Too much of us do not have an heart of compassion. Are we only thinking about ourselves? For God to use you, you must love people. You must love people. Don't watch the profile with the position carry. I work with a set of people, you see. And what I found out working with them, the reason why they fail, them don't love people. Them say them not a people person. And if you're not a people person, what you're doing in the business of serving people? It's not a profile business. Eh? When you love people, and you love God, you pour out your heart to help them. You give what you have to ensure that they are all right, if you are all right. May God give us a heart to love people as God loves people. What is in your hand? A rod. What do you have? Regardless what you have, God can use it and do great things for you. So we're going to sing in closing the song again. And our dear brother is coming up, so I know he's going to help me out. Yeah? Because I don't have no golden voice, you know. But I'm going to sing, because this is the voice that God gave me. Yes, man. You get it? Yes, man. Make a joyful night unto the Lord. Make a joyful night unto the Lord. Use what God give you, and don't be afraid. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Let us stand to our feet as we sing that song. As we sing that song, asking God, if you can't stand because you're a child, I understand.
You can use anything, Lord, you can use me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Ooh, take my hands, Lord, and my feet. Touch my heart, Lord, speak to me. If you can use anything, Lord, can use me. Oh God, if you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Oh Lord, oh God, if you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Oh mighty God, take my hands, Lord, and my feet. Touch my heart, Lord, speak to me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me.
God and Heavenly Father, you have demonstrated through the ages that you can use anything on request this afternoon, Lord. As we make ourselves available to you, use us to glorify yourself and to bring others to your kingdom. Touch your hearts, Lord. Touch your hands, touch your feet. Speak to us, Lord, because we want to be used by you. Glorify yourself even now as we give you thanks and praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Every word you say is true.